Welcome to the glass plate. In one of the earlier examples, we discussed a perfect sphere, a presse papier, being made at a temperature of about 100 degrees and that has to cool down. And we analyzed the situation when we take it out of the oven and it's no longer 100 but now 70 degrees Celsius, put it in the air here at room temperature, assume that there is no resistance here, how long does it take to cool it down? And we computed a little over an hour. But obviously in real life there is some resistance here. So in an example of today we're going to include that. So not only is there resistance here, but there is also resistance there. And I will give a Nusselt number for that with a subscript x from external equal to 20. The question is, again, I would like to have the average temperature of the sphere cool down to 30 degrees. How long does it take? Okay, let's review the situation. On the inside, it's still unsteady conduction through a sphere. That is the same as in the simpler example. On the outside, Nusselt is non-zero, is not infinite, so there is resistance. And thus, I cannot assume that the temperature of 20 degrees is all the way up to the surface of the sphere present. There is also a slight drop in temperature, or even a large one, I don't know yet, that I have to account for. The driving force is still from the inside, the mean if you want, to the 20 degrees, but now also partly through air. I can no longer use the graphs, as that strictly required that the temperature on the outside of the sphere is set at time equals zero to a fixed value, the 20 in our case, and kept there. But I don't control this temperature. I only control the surroundings. What is the alternative? We can still try and set up a balance. So we're going to answer this by setting up a heat balance over the sphere. That is our control volume. And the energy, as it's unsteady, changes over time. So the ddt equals in minus out plus production, as always, has here a non-zero term. Actually, this is the ddt of rho cp v times the average temperature, all taken of the sphere. There is no inflow, there's no production. The outflow can be written as a total heat transfer coefficient u times A times the driving force, for which we take T average minus T of the surrounding. And we are faced with having to solve this differential equation. Obviously, I can do that provided that I know U. If I don't know U, then it's pretty useless. But U is 1 over the total resistance, which is the sum of the total resistance of the resistances internal and external. And for each I know a Nusselt number. Because this internal inside the sphere is still conduction unsteady in the sphere, so Nusselt here is 6.6. External Nusselt was prescribed in this case as being 20. Once I know the Nusselt numbers, I can compute H, so the internal H is Nusselt internal times lambda internal over the diameter, and I computed that and I got out a number 13.2 watt per meter square Kelvin. External, I will have something similar. H external is Nusselt external times lambda of air, because we're now on the outside of the sphere, over D. And if I compute that, I found 5.2 watt per meter square Kelvin. These are roughly the same. So I cannot scratch out one of the two and pin down that the resistance is either inside or outside. The resistances are more or less the same. So I need to have U. But I just use this and find my U. It is 3.7 watt per meter square Kelvin. And it's a constant. Now I need to solve this equation. And I know how to do that. And I can write it here in the middle. I'll guide you through how that works. Rho, Cp, and V are constants. Take it out, move to the right-hand side. A and V are the surface area of a sphere, pi diameter squared, volume pi over 6, diameter cubed. So the differential equation can be written as ddt, the change of the temperature, equals minus 6 over rho Cp d, all of the perspex, times the driving force, T minus T, 0. This is T. Well, I better call this infinite. Let me rewrite it far away. That's an easier notation. Okay. Can I solve the differential equation? Yes, I can. I'm going to separate the variables, so everything with temperature goes to this side. Everything else goes to the other side. I've forgotten the U here that I need to put in. 6 U over rho Cp d dt. Solution being the logarithm of the temperature drop equals minus 6 U rho Cp diameter time plus an integration constant, big C. I find that from the initial condition at T equals 0, the average temperature is 70 degrees, T0. And thus, I can get my solution as the average temperature minus the temperature far away over the initial temperature minus the temperature far away is the exponent of minus 6 U rho Cp dt. Just fits. I got my general expression. Now I can fill in 30 degrees, 20, 70, 20. All these numbers except for time I know, and it gives me a cooling time of 21 hours. Much longer than in the case when you neglect the resistance here. So that does matter. Recap. I realized that there is resistance on the outside that I cannot neglect, so the boundary is not fixed at my 20 degrees. The driving force is further away from the sphere. Then the graphs don't work. It's still unsteady, internally conduction, externally I don't know, I don't need to know because the Nusselt is given. Then I set up a heat balance for the sphere, compute the change of the internal energy as heat is flowing out, try and solve my differential equation, look carefully at the overall heat resistance or the overall heat transfer coefficient, solve my differential equation, fill in the knowns to find the unknown temperature of 21 hours. This one is obviously quite a bit tougher than the earlier one where you could use the graphs.